How does the mention of colonizing Mars entice you? Can you even believe it? Oh yes, we are talking about settling on Mars for real. Elon Musk, the richest man on Earth, has always expressed his enthusiasm for taking human life to the next level. All thanks to NASA's discovery and relentless research to look for signs of life on the red planet, Musk's aspirations may prove to be true in the coming years. It was just a few months ago when Musk announced that within 5.5 years, humans will get the chance to travel to Mars. Now that's intriguing for sure. The Tesla and SpaceX CEO has made an insane discovery and expressed his ambition of making the Martian civilization a self-sustaining one. In today's video, we will share with you the most interesting tale of human settlement on the Martian surface. With that being said, welcome to Elon Musk Weekly. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press that bell icon, as we will be your number one place for the latest Elon Musk, Tesla, and SpaceX related news. Elon Musk has made a super ambitious claim of confirming that 1 million humans could live on Mars by the 2060s. Surprised? We are yet to unbox the pack of discoveries that Musk has come up with. Recently, after announcing that his company SpaceX has commenced building an orbital launch pad at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, Musk made yet another interesting revelation that started the development of Starship, which is a bulky next-generation rocket. Guess what? This very rocket of SpaceX is going to be used to transport cargo as well as humans to the moon and the red planet. Musk's tweet read, "We will soon make these real." Folks all over the world have got crazy since then. Musk has unveiled his ever-ambitious plan of introducing the SpaceX Interplanetary System. An exceptionally big rocket of 200 feet is going to be used to materialize this goal. This sophisticated system will involve a spacecraft that will be crowded with astronauts. It will deploy on the top of a 39-foot-wide booster that exerts a mammoth force of 28 million pounds. By making use of 42 Raptor engines with which it is going to be endowed, the booster will enhance the assemblage to 5,374 miles per hour. What is rather astonishing is to know that the entire spacecraft of SpaceX is way more powerful than Saturn V of NASA. This very Saturn V has the record of being the biggest rocket built to date, and it had carried the Apollo missions to the moon. Well, do you know what's even more fascinating? The SpaceX rocket is also going to be deployed in space from the identical launch pad like that of Saturn V, or 39A, at Kennedy Space Center, Cape Canaveral in Florida. The need for another planet to support human life has become way too crucial. Because, well, let's face it, the human population is on the rise and it doesn't seem to stop anytime soon. Funnily enough, the Earth is also not going to grow bigger. So the need to make life extraterrestrial has become urgent. Musk's killer plans are sure to shock anyone. He plans to develop a prosperous, full-scale city on the Martian surface. He intends to erect a metropolis where everyone would have the right to live. Apart from scientists, astronomers, and researchers, any common people would be able to settle there. Beginning a new life on a whole new planet undoubtedly sounds exciting. The best thing is that you can even get a loan to travel all the way to the Martian world. You can later repay the loan by working in any place, be it an iron mill, pizzeria, or any other kind of commercial or retail store. Of course, these have to be on Mars. Among all the exciting discoveries made by Musk, this has to be the most special and shocking. As we all know, to survive on the planet, we need water. But does the Martian surface contain water? Well, yes. In a recent discovery made by NASA and Elon Musk, it has revealed that water is indeed present on the Martian surface. Hopes of folks existing on Mars since then have risen dramatically. Technically, it is not water, but huge chunks of cross-sections of ice that have been found about 100 meters below the Martian surface. Beneath 1 mile of the northern pole of Mars are located the Great Layers of Ice. And guess what? This very ice can support human life on the red planet. No wonder this is the most sensational discovery made by Elon Musk in collaboration with NASA. It was in 2019 when Musk expressed his desire to establish a self-sustaining civilization on Mars. This means that the planet would be able to thrive and sustain itself without being dependent upon any other aspects. But achieving this great milestone is not going to be a bed of roses because, well, it is strewn with thorns too. This is because to achieve the goal of self-sustainance, about 1 million tons of cargo would be required to be shipped to Mars. Well, these could be transported to the Red Planet by the soon-to-be-launched Starship. But to do that, Musk has to spend $100,000 per ton. The outcome is such that Mars City is going to cost roughly $100 billion. Isn't that incredible? However, Musk estimates that his insane invention of a Red Planet city is going to be a $10 trillion project. Now, that is quite a lot. To achieve his ambitious goal, Musk would likely be collaborating with NASA. He wants to make humans a multi-planetary species. If Earth ever experiences a catastrophe, humans would at least survive and be able to start anew on the other planet, Mars. At a public event in 2016, Musk had remarked, "History is going to bifurcate along two directions. Either we're going to become a multi-planetary species and a spacefaring civilization, or we're going to be stuck on one planet until some eventual extinction event." This lofty plan of settling on Mars has been hatched to ensure that human life doesn't come to an end. Initially, to start with, the SpaceX rocket would launch the crew capsule for it to orbit around Earth. Afterwards, the booster would get directed towards making a delicate landing at the launch pad. Rocket boosters of SpaceX have always functioned in this manner, so there is nothing unusual about it. The booster then will take a fuel tanker and carry it to orbit, where the spacecraft will be fueled for its journey ahead towards Mars. Once it has started embarking on its journey towards the Red Planet, the spaceship would launch the solar panels to cultivate renewable energy from the sun. It would also preserve precious propellant to ensure an exciting landing is ensured on Mars. But the crew capsules won't be able to reach Mars before the conductive planetary alignment occurs. Till then, the capsules would have to fixate themselves on the orbit. Such a planetary alignment that occurs every 26 months brings Earth and Mars closer together. Isn't it exciting to know that 1,000 or more spaceships would be waiting in orbit for that special positioning to occur? Musk also intends to reuse as many spaceships as possible in the process. According to him, reusability is a great factor and it is fundamental to making Mars a self-sustaining planet. Though it was planned that 100 people would be riding each spaceship, the number has now increased to 200. So yes, 200 humans would be able to get an exclusive view of Mars for the very first time. In this relentless pursuit of colonizing Mars, Musk plans to use a single rocket booster about 1,000 times, a tanker 100 times, and each spaceship about 12 times. Do you know that this won't be a one-way trip to Mars? Because, well, people do need to get the option of returning to Earth. In that way, you can commute from Mars to Earth and vice versa. Musk also intends to build space hotels, but if you ask when, well, we're afraid we don't know that yet. The Martian landscape is quite treacherous. As a result, a lot of things have to be fixed before humans start colonizing the Red Planet. Chances are that Musk is going to terraform Mars. Wondering what that is? Well, Musk anticipates laying down a plan by which SpaceX desires to transform Mars so that it looks like Earth and thus makes the existence of life possible there. In fact, at the headquarters of SpaceX, the company has put up two images of Mars, one in its actual form and the other in its terraformed version. The present average surface temperature of Mars is estimated to be minus 60 degrees Celsius, equivalent to minus 82 degrees Fahrenheit. Musk has come up with an innovative plan by which he wishes to heat the poles of Mars to free up the reserves of frozen carbon dioxide, as a result of which a series of low fallout nuclear fusion explosions are going to be used. That in turn will portray the role of artificial suns. The carbon dioxide stores must be used, because only then a friendly atmosphere on Mars can be created. Ultimately, when humans will land on the Martian surface, they can do fine by just depending on their breathing apparatus. Things won't be difficult then, as far as breathing is concerned. Earth has an atmospheric pressure of about 1,000 millibars at sea level. Interestingly, in a research paper, it was revealed that if the carbon-rich sedimentary rocks of Mars could be vaporized, enough gas that would account for 12 millibars of atmospheric pressure. so you can understand the stark comparison in atmospheric pressure between the two planets. Anyway, the plans of terraforming Mars are going to take a lot of time. At the moment, Musk has busied himself with working towards the red planet city on Mars first. It is his first priority at the moment. After this dream of the SpaceX CEO gets materialized, he may venture into terraforming Mars. As of now, nothing of such sort is going to happen. Unfortunately, there is a hurdle lying ahead in the way of Musk. Since the cost of the trip to the red planet is way too high, the Mars enthusiast wants to bring it down to $200,000, which is more or less the average price of a house in the US. However, that's going to be a notable decrease from the current cost estimates. But Musk has a solution to this problem, as he has already said. I think we want to try to get as much in the way of private resources dedicated to the cause, and then get as much as possible in the way of government resources, so that if any one of those funding sources disappears, things continue. No matter what the nature of the hurdle is, Musk's determination will surely make him find a solution by which all obstacles can be overcome. The SpaceX CEO will finally help us live our dreams of settling on Mars, rather than staying in awe and surprise as to whether this planet will support life. According to Musk, "I think that Mars is going to be a great place to go. It will be the planet of opportunity. Lots of wonderful surprises are awaiting us. Let's just wait and see how things turn out." How excited are you to settle on an altogether new planet? Let us know what you think in the comments section below. Also, if you enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of the latest Elon Musk updates. Thanks a lot for watching the video till the end. Be sure to check out our next highlighted video, Here For You, and we will see you there.